Hi amigos, welcome back to my channel Amigos Recipes. In today's Sunday series, we'll be talking about coriander leaves. Coriander leaf is one of the basic element of our kitchen, which goes into many recipes. But are we aware about all the pros and cons of the elements that we are putting in our food? No, but don't you think so? We must. So let's start with coriander leaves. Coriander leaves are added in our food as they enhances the flavor and aroma of our food. But it is not limited to that. It does add a lot of nutritional value also to our food. Coriander leaves are a good source of vitamin A, C, E, K, also calcium, iron, potassium, magnesium, and it is a good source of dietary fiber also. Vitamin K and calcium in coriander helps in building the strong bones, teeth, and hair. Few researches have proved that coriander is an anti-diabetic plant and it also helps in lowering the cholesterol and blood pressure. Along with some food items, some heavy metals also enter in our body like cadmium, aluminium, lead, etc. Once they enter in our body, sometimes they try to resident in our tissue, which leads to heart disease, hormonal imbalance, infertility, and many others. But consuming coriander on regular basis loosens up these heavy metals from the tissue and facilitates the way to flush them out from our body. Through its natural sedative effect, coriander helps in maintaining the sleep cycle, it calms down the nerves, and even improves the quality of sleep. There are many benefits of having coriander water early morning. Soak 1/2 cup of coriander leaves in 2 cups of water at night. Early morning, drain out the leaves and have only the water. This will help you in reducing the weight, maintaining the cholesterol level, reducing the blood pressure, and prevents from all the urinary tract related infection. Coriander also protects against food poisoning. Through water or many food items, we tend to suffer from food poisoning. But the coriander leaves are antibacterial in nature, which protects you from food poisoning, cholera, diarrhea, etc. I hope that now you know that coriander is not only a basic element of our food, but it plays very major role in our health also. But nothing in this world comes without cons also. So everything which have the positivity, it does carry some negativity also. What is the negative part in coriander? Its negative part is active only when we have it in excess amount. Having coriander in excess amount damages the liver, leads to stomach related problem and breathing problem also. So it is always suggestible that to have coriander in your food, but it should be in controlled amount, not to add in every item as it protects you from many life-threatening disease. So now as we have discussed both the positive and negative aspect of coriander, let's see how we can protect it for longer time. Over here you can see we have taken a bunch of coriander. Now we'll cut out the root part. And check if there is any black leaf. Just take it out. Now wash it thoroughly under running water. Once done, take kitchen towel and place the coriander over it for about 1.5 hours to dry. After 1.5 hours, we'll take it aside. Now we'll take kitchen towel and place the coriander in small bunch. Now we'll roll it. Take a Ziploc pouch, place coriander at the bottom and stuff. By this method, you can preserve your coriander for around 15 days. We hope that all this research and sharing was useful to you. If you like this video, do hit the like button. And if you have still not subscribed to our channel, do subscribe to it now. Thank you. Bye-bye.